So this is a good thing because it's kind of like apples and oranges. We're completely different from what you did, but we are a startup. You're seeing for the first time today what our company is about. So this is a rollout for us. We have a company motto that's excellence at the speed of now. What's better than now, right? That's myself, David Ayala. My partner is John Conway. John couldn't be here today, so I'm going to speak for him. I probably won't do a very good job, but I'll do my best. And who says you can't be an old entrepreneur, right? Didn't he do it? There you go. I see you nodding. If Ocala is the horse capital of the world, then why not be the logistics capital of the world? We think we have the potential for it. We're here as a new distribution hub, the perfect solution to the Tampa, Orlando, Gainesville triangle, which are really saturated and the costs are going up there. So Ocala is in a perfect spot. And so we are thinking of being a resource for our community. We have a motto of start small, think big, and move quickly. We had the opportunity this year to go to the MODEX 2018 show, the Material Handling Industry Association in Atlanta, and the potential is incredible for what we're trying to do. At this point, our focus is going to be individuals as far as skill development is concerned, a great need in our community. We have open jobs here. We don't have the workforce necessary for the larger companies coming to town. We think we have the potential for that. I'm currently the global logistics teacher at Westport High School. The school board has an excellent commitment to expanding career and technical education. We want you to support that. A second global logistics teacher has been hired at Westport, and there's also an academy out at Lake Weir. At this point, I'm going to ask Ryan to click on the left and see someone we all might know tell us a little bit more about career and technical ed.
Bluehost makes it easy to get your passion online. Personally, I shy away from words like middle skills because it just implies over here there's a top skill and down here there's a bottom skill. I say work smart and hard. It doesn't make sense to slam a four-year degree any more than it makes sense to slam a welding pursuit. That's a way out for thousands of people, and they're simply not hip to it because nobody is walking them through the process. I saw help wanted signs in every single state at the height of the recession, and I would talk to usually young people who were just getting started in these jobs, and they were excited to learn a new thing. I just saw more optimism at a really dark time, and I was covered in dirt when it happened, and so was everybody around me. We have 4 million jobs right now. A very, very small percentage of them require a four-year degree. Most require training.
Training needs to come up here.
So we either make training cool, or we continue to look at lots and lots of people looking for jobs, and lots of available jobs, and no logical way to connect the two. And that would be like having a head without a body.
So one of our goals, as Mike Rowe just said, that we got a chance to see him as a keynote speaker at MODEX, is to make training cool. A lot of kids don't think that training is cool. So we want to do what build on what the CEP has done for our community to date and work with our distribution and logistics companies here in the Marion County area. So what is the current state of the warehouse workforce? Our emphasis obviously is in warehouse distribution and transportation. Who knows what the average amount for which an employee will leave one warehouse job for another? Anybody know? You're close, $1.50. They'll leave for $1.50. Obviously, workforce retention is an issue in every community, but especially in Marion County. I've heard countless stories about job abandonment and really a lack of work ethic or a lack of commitment. There are a lot of reasons for it, but here are some of the key reasons. What's the average amount invested in the learning curve of a warehouse employee? What does a company invest to get a worker up to speed? Pretty much just a single employee, let's say 2 weeks worth of training, get them up to speed, turn them loose on the frontline job. What do you think it might be?
$15,000.
It's $1,800 per employee. That's a front-end investment, before you even get started on that employee returning on your investment. That's the value proposition. What's the increase of the average forklift driver's starting wage in the past 4 years? This is an indication of costs going up, is it not? There's only two ways to impact a company's profitability. One is to decrease or control costs. The other is to increase your revenues. Those are the only two ways to make money in a business, right? So if our costs are going up, they're going up from $10.50 to an average of $13 an hour for a forklift driver, because one of the things we're going to do is offer forklift certification, which I am certified to do. What's one of the most important job factors to the average hourly worker? If you want to retain a worker, what is one of the things that workers today are asking for? Benefits. Believe it or not, it's flexibility. I don't want to work the solid 9 to 5. Maybe I don't want to do that tomorrow. Tomorrow I want to do 10 to 12 or what have you. So flexibility in terms of their work hours and their commitment to the company is what they're looking for. And finally, what is the main reason employees quit? It's a national survey. Their immediate supervisor is the main reason someone leaves their jobs. I have left the job because of an immediate supervisor. I won't stay around and make trouble. My work ethic says I don't fit in here. This isn't working for me, so I'm going to leave, which is the right thing to do. So those are the kinds of things that my company wants to address. We'll partner with you to answer two questions. Where do we want to be in 1 year? Where do we want to be in 3 years? If you want to reach us, those are our email addresses, and of course we have a website. I don't know if Ryan, during the question and answer session, you can bring up the website. And if you go on there, you're going to get a banner that allows you to give us your email address to sign up for our newsletter. Now, we're moving into our new offices this Friday. Going to be a really busy June for us, probably putting in really long days. We'd like to do a rollout to begin our operations on July 1. So in your folders, you're going to see our press release and letting you know where we're at and begin our operations on July 1st. How am I doing on time as I'm running? Okay, very quickly, we see a number of business channels that we're going to be involved with. It centers around the strengths that John and I have as individuals. Between us, we have 80 man years of experience in these fields. So we refer to Redbird Resources as our business resources division. We identify problems, we provide consulting services, we'll do management training to make those supervisors and managers better at managing employees, which we have done. And we may even consider outsourced training on a contractual basis for companies who would like to cost, who would like to cut that $1,800 cost. We think we can do it for a much better value proposition. Redbird Logistics is distribution resources. We are trademarking something called Definite Logistics, where we engage in warehouse analytics and transportation metrics. I have a lot of information for you, so I'm moving pretty quickly. We can talk offline, or you can have us come out at no obligation, no cost, to talk to you about how to improve your business. Matter of fact, we can do it for our horse friend here. Might want to talk about rolling that business out. CTE Resources, Rise and Soar series, is a series of training programs that we are going to put in place. And we want to work with the school districts around the country. Our business is very scalable. We intend to begin in the North Central Florida area. We can roll this out through the Department of Education to the entire state of Florida. Then we can go regional, and then we can go along. My emphasis would be the I-75, I-65 corridor from Miami to Chicago, because I am so familiar with it since I started my career and got my education in Chicago. There's a lot of business in all those cities, and I've lived along all those major cities along that corridor. So there's a lot of familiarity there. Interesting here, industry certifications. I hold a CLT myself from MSSC, and we have the Definite Skills series centered around logistics skills certifications, and we also offer a unique sales skills course where you can become a much more effective person and increase your sales for your company. We teach soft skills as well. The number one demand by employers today that I have heard is that we need employees with soft skills. People who will know how to talk, how to walk in some cases, how to dress, and a lot of other things like that, because who are you? You are your employees. You're only as good as your weakest link, right? As your weakest employee. So we are going to engage in vetting and placement as well. So I think we're going to work very well in tandem with the school districts for that. But also there are a lot of folks out there who want to take themselves to the next level and we're going to be prepared to do that. And finally, we're excited about a proprietary piece of software, a warehouse management system we have. We call it IBIS. It's in beta testing now. We expect the rollout around September 1st. And it is something that small businesses can purchase. It is a perpetual license. There's no subscription or ongoing charges. And it's the price is based on scale, depending on what you need, anywhere from one user to 100 users. And it engages in a lot of things, especially barcoding integration from GTIN, which is Global Trade Identification Number, to UPC, which is a 12 to 13 digit barcode. We do code it'll do code 39, it'll do code 128, so we can certainly provide all the barcodes necessary for that. Without getting too much into it, it will slot optimize in a warehouse, and an exciting thing nowadays is cartonization. What size box do I need for the order that I am processing now? Because it will cube every item in your warehouse, take its weight, and when you assemble an order, it will tell you what box you need to put it in. How many of you gotten some from Amazon where it's a box this big and there's an item this big in it? And a lot of stuff, a lot of dunnage in there, a lot of protection, right? What a waste. There are places where you can cut costs, and we're all in business, and we all know that. There is room for improvement in every business. That's what Six Sigma is about. And so continuous improvement is something that our company can look for and help your company optimize its profitability. And we're very excited about something in the works. It's under wraps, just about done. Redbird Runner, this is our future vision. We're working on a last mile solution. They say the next Bill Gates is the person who solves the last mile problem that most companies have because of those rising costs. So we're excited about, I'm not going to get into this, these are the benefits. You're more than happy to write to me. I will send you a copy of the PowerPoint. And we have a proposition for you. 10 winners in 10 days. We are offering 10 companies between June 10th and June 19th. We want to offer 10 companies a free evaluation. Let us come in. We'll have a conversation. And we will present you with an actual profit improvement proposal. We call it a PIP. And we will give you that at no cost pro bono. So it's valued at $1,000. And by the way, who knows who that is on the $1,000 bill? Anybody know? Come on. It's Grover Cleveland. Don't we all know Grover Cleveland? I mean, after all, right? So anyway, it's valued at $1,000. All right, so rise and soar, Redbird Runner. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.